Hello, everybody, and welcome back to my time at Sandrock, where, oh my goodness, look at my face. Don't look at my face, actually. Sorting out my face. I had a bit of a late night last night, that one. I was looking for treasure chests, and I got a little bit carried away. So, yeah.
Howdy, partner. That's Sandrockanese for hello. Hope you got plenty of rest. I've prepared the route for our builder cruise.
Okay, let's go on the builder
cruise.
First stop,
the train station. You might have noticed that the floorboards on the platform there are all full of potholes. Well, that ends today. Let's go!
Let's go, builder cruise! Ah, in the station office? Okay.
Here we are. Let's fix these holes.
Oh, like Mian can fix. Oh, I get to fix one, do I? Okay.
That'll do it. On to the next target. The fence surrounding Martel's Oasis. Builder crews, roll out.
Okay, builder crews, roll out. Off we go. What this?
All right, here we are. Now, is it just me, or is this fence just a little lacking in the looking department? No offense. No offense to our friend here, the fence. Get it?
Yes, I got it.
Let's fix up the wonky looking parts and then move on.
All right, fix the wonky fence.
Make a pretty good team, huh? We got that done in a flash. All right, on to our next mission. Beach installation in town square. You see, one day, I noticed Vivi walking all over town, looking kind of drained. When it suddenly hit me, there's nowhere to sit down anywhere in the center of town. Thus, benches.
Good grief, that bench, like, it's been there forever in my EA run, and I'd forgotten that I'd even put it down. It was something that we did. Forget half the stuff I do. All right, bench installation in town center. Well, there's a bench there. Apparently there needs to also be one on the other side.
This looks like a pretty good spot. Say, let's see who can build up a bench faster. Ready? Go!
Totally me.
Nice. But the real winners are the tired, the weary, the huddled masses yearning to sit freely. Now they have these super cool benches to rest on. You know, I was actually also thinking we should add some shrubbery. Maybe some flowers. But this soil is just so barren.
Yeah.
Well, that's neither here nor there. We did good today. Here, a little something as a token of my appreciation. You didn't have to join me on this thing. But I'm glad you did. Let's do it again sometime.
Okay. Sounds good. 20 Mian relationship and also 20 workshop reputation. Aha. Fantastic. Mian kind of disappeared though. Let's say hello to Macchiato at the very least.
Meow. Meow.
I'm going to give you a cactus fruit. Meow. Because I'd rather give you something that I don't need much of and get 1 point than get nothing. Okay. There's something going on in Arvio's shop. Oh yes, I need to tell Arvio that I delivered the package. Is Arvio in here? Ah. Rats. Anything else that we need to do today? Let's have a little look at my log. So, I still need to grab some glass from my workshop, but there are no other quests apparently to do at the momento, but there are a few things over at the ranch and there's a letter waiting for me, so I should probably just run back. Maybe Arvio will come out a bit later. So how am I doing for points with Mian now? I think that should be decent. Yeah, nearly 2 hearts. Oh, she ran back to her. She probably ran back to her house. She runs faster than me. It's so annoying. I I can never play critters. This is Leanne's house. She's quite a big house, actually. I wanted to play critters with you. Because this is basically my cheating way to get everybody to be friends with me. Wow, we're choosing exactly the same things. We are so in tune with each other. Haha! I won at cards 20 times and I got an achievement. What? That's victory. Nice. Mian got that one. I'm gonna go fox again, I think. Elephant. Elephant again. Fox. And I'm gonna go mouse because you haven't gone elephant yet. Ah, okay, right. 15 relationship points for that. That's fantastic. That is now us up to almost buddy status with Mian. That's actually higher than I ever got in my entire early access run by 13 days in. Considering my early access run was 4 years long, or maybe three, it was at least 3 years long. Yes, so yeah. Okay, so Arvio's still. Okay, we've still got that chest. Oh yeah, the chest that might be inside the apartments. Because that is the only place I can possibly think it might be, because I am absolutely doing my nut. I've no idea. Where that chest is, and I'm obsessed. Must be buddies with Katori. There is none up here. No chest in here. Must be buddies with Grace to enter. This one's empty. Right, so I don't think it's up here. Unless it's in somebody's bedroom. Not in the main common areas. Not in here. Or in here. And that is Jensen's place. Okay, interesting. I am extremely confused as to where that is. I feel like I've looked almost everywhere. I've done this several times, like gone up on the roof. Sorry, Pen. It's an emergency. It basically should be right here. I don't think it could possibly be inside the temple. Definitely not up on the rooftops. It's definitely not here. It's definitely 100% not underneath here, as far as I can tell. Unless, I don't know, I have to vacuum up the sand pit with like my vacuum cleaner or something. Nope. Okay. So I am utterly at a loss. If anybody does know where that is, let me know in the comments. Kind of should be almost exactly here. It just isn't. Unless it's in here. But that's going to be for sale. No, so that has completely confused me. The only other thing is I'll have a look in Amira's house, just in case it's somehow in there. I don't think so though. And I'm pretty sure that it should be outside if it needs to be outside. Look at all these cuties! You can get an Owen one now. I can't remember which ones you could get. I think you could always get the ginger one. I think you could always get Arvio and Amira. And possibly always Mia. And I think Elsie and Owen might be new. You can get those on Amazon apparently. Arvio! Hello! Did your quest.
You've already delivered it? That was quick! I really don't know what I would have done without you.
Nice! Yeah, I'm getting to a point now where I'm not seeing, like, chests popping up around the place, with the exception of that one that I can't find. So it's definitely going to be easy for you guys to identify that one and tell me, like, if you know where it is. There's a possibility it could be inside the shop, maybe? But yeah, look all around here. It looks like I've gotten basically all of the chests and things around there. Most of the ones sort of around the temple and things. Around the clinic. Oh, you know what I didn't do? Or did I? Can't remember whether I went to see Fang yesterday. I think I might have done because I think I might that might have been the one that made me fast.
Excuse me, ma'am. Might I have a word? I'm new to Sandrock and I would be remiss to pass up an opportunity to speak with a dignified looking damsel such as yourself.
My stars! Did you listen to that? I reckon that must be the phrasings of a bona fide Tauren gentleman. Ain't nobody talks fancy like that around here.
Well, what can I do you for, newcomer?
Looking for good eats? Or just a place to kick up your heels? I've been ranching these parts for more than 20 years. Reckon I ought to know a thing or two by now. Just ask our builder here.
I believe you. I'm Ernest, by the way. I'm here on the behalf of the Atara Times. I was hoping to do a piece on that bandit fellow who's been giving you all so much trouble. Would you care to weigh in on the situation?
Oh. I reckon you mean Logan. Mr. Ernie, sir, I don't suppose you were on that train, were you? You still want to catch up with that rascal? Well, here's my weighing in. You'd do best by packing your bags. That Logan's a wanted man, and he likely won't take kindly to a fancy talking, pants wearing, city slicking Point Dexter snooping around. No offense. If you want to write about something, write about the scenery. Try some of our Yakmol sausage. It's so good, people all the way from Portia make their way over to stock up on it. Logan, forget about it. Wait till the Corps catches him, then ask him yourself.
And it was going so well. I've really hit a wall these past few days. Can't seem to get anyone to open up. Are they really so afraid of one guy? Is it my cologne?
I guess they're afraid.
Builder, despite all that, I don't suppose you would be willing to answer some of my questions about Logan.
I don't really know him, but you can ask.
Really? You will? Fantastic! One moment, let me just get out my notebook. For this interview, please try to be as objective as possible. Try not to let your feelings or any biases get in the way. It's important that I only get the facts as I try to understand this bandit persona. First question, do you know Logan personally?
Never met him.
That's all right. Still, you've lived here for a while, haven't you? I believe your insight may yet be of use. Tell me what he looks like. I mean, have you seen the posters around here? They really couldn't have found a picture of him without a bandana over his face. Just a simple description will do.
He's hot.
Oh no, he's hot. Why does everybody keep saying that? I'd say, rather, Logan has a disarming glare. Ice cold. I'll never forget it. And even through the bandana, you can see there are stories written on his face just waiting to be told.
Well, if you were gonna make it up, why did you bother asking me?
Logan's accomplice, the man who helped him on the train. What do you know about him? What's his name?
That's Harrow, his oldest friend.
Harrow and Logan. I see. Yes, I noticed that they seemed to be close. Each one seemed to know what the other was about to do from just a quick glance. So that's all you know? Well, I appreciate your honesty. As a non-native Sandrocker, I suppose I should have expected as much. But I can tell you did your best. Thank you. In any case, I suppose this counts as my first complete interview. They sent me here to just do a little throwaway piece for Ernie's World. But this whole bandit thing is gold! My editor Eduardo is gonna flip. Bandits? On your train? It's more likely than you think. No, that's no good. Ne'er-do-well nabs, Nada? No, how cheesy is that? Hey there, kiddo. I seem to keep seeing you around. You're not following me, are you? Are you all right?
I'm fine.
Are you lost? Where's your mother?
I'm not lost. I live here. My ma's in the desert now.
Ah, I see. In the desert. Oh, goodness. Sweetie, where do you live? Do you need someone to help you get home?
Oh, she's fine. She's just living up the road with Vivi's house.
No, you're Ernest, the writer. Did you write the Maltese Pigeon?
Oh, you're a fan, huh? Gosh, why didn't you say so? Oh, that book you've got, that's my latest release. Why don't I sign it for you?
Oh, that would be great! Thank you, Mr. Ernest!
Hey, anything for a fan. Who should I make this out to?
Jasmine. That's J-A-S.
And Jasmine, sweetie, why don't you tell me, what was your favorite part about this book?
Actually, I thought the story this time was a bit contrived.
Eh? Contrived? Wow, such a big girl word. Where did you...
I'm not finished. The characters are paper thin. And if you've even been paying half attention, you can see every twist coming from a league away. I think you've been really writing it in lately. Your old stuff was way better.
Well, little kid, with all due respect, you're a little kid and you don't know anything.
Yeah, she sounds like she doesn't know anything. Completely just uneducated, hasn't got a clue. Really, Ernest?
I'm your primary demographic!
Actually, as you can clearly see displayed on the back cover, the book is intended for all ages. Well, that's all the time I have for today. Here you go, and cheerio!
Wow, look, Mr. Teddy! We got an autograph from Ernest, the famous writer! Let's put it under our pillow tonight!
You really can't please everyone. She's kind of right, though. My novels have only ever really caught on with the under 12 demographic. It's gone so hard to continue to outdo myself.
You write books?
Yes! The Maltese Pigeon is my most famous work. It's a classical whodunit mystery where it turns out it was the butler all along. Oops, guess I spoiled it for you. Well, it's still good. I recommend you check it out.
Wow, a whodunit story where it was the butler all along? Whoever would have guessed?
Anyway, that little girl sounded a lot like my critics in Walnut Grove. They rated my latest novel a rotten score of 3 walnuts out of 10. But, I don't write for them. I write from the heart, okay?
Yeah, but if you wrote from the heart and it was still rubbish, then you probably still do need to improve, right? And take on criticism and...
It was nice running into you again, Builder. But I really should get back to work. Despite the one-off critic here and there, plenty of fans are in fact looking forward to what I come up with in Sandrock. So long!
Maybe not. Right, so we got lots of points with Ernest there, actually, looking at this. I think we're probably going to already have a little bit of... Yeah, already got a little bit of a heart going on there. Fantastic. Okay, let's see if I can fix the glass on the train now. I think that would be the next thing to do, and then grab a commission for the day. Surely that's got to be finished by now, right? Oh, and maybe read my mail as well. So, do we now have 10 pieces of glass? We do. Lovely. Shall we read the mail? Yes. Workshop upgrade. Congratulations on building your workshop up to a 2-star rating. You can now get 2 commissions at a time. More commissions, more money. Maybe you're not such a newbie anymore, but you've still got a long way to go. Huh? What are you still reading for? I told you you can get higher level commissions with the higher ranks. So stop reading this letter and get to the Commerce Guild on the double. Go, go, go. Thank you, Yan. Yan never even signs his letters, Yan. Just goes, Commerce Guild. So I can take 2 commissions now. So this may well be my way of catching up for the second half of the month with where Yan's at. So, copper pipe. Can make that on the grinder, I'm pretty sure. Hardwood planks. Yep, taking both of those. Because I have all the stuff I need to do them now. So I'm pretty sure I can get on with that. I'm at 524 points. The 60 odd points that I get from that could take me up to close to 600 today. If I play my cards right. So let's get going. Let's get some copper on the grinder. And get the stuff going for hardwood planks. Copper pipes times 3 so I can instantly build those, but I'm running low on copper now. Can I put some copper onto my furnaces? Yeah. Let's get copper going on that furnace. Let's see if I can get bronze going maybe on this one. I can. Do I have anything that can be recycled at the moment? No, I haven't picked up any scrap recently. I could do with getting into the junkyard and doing that. And hardwood planks, I'm going to need hardwood, which I can get with my new and improved bronze axe, which is here. Let's go and find some hardwood. I need 3 hardwood planks, so I already have 2 from somewhere. Probably from pulling apart chests. That's actually been really quite handy. There was loads of hardwood around here before. Where has it gone now? Well, there's some by these Yakmel. Okay. Quality wood scrap. And there's also like a tree trunk down there that may give me some... That didn't give me any hardwood at all. Deadwood? Okay, yeah, I can chop this. Nice. This might give me some hardwood. I think because it's a fallen tree already, it's deadwood, I'm pretty sure I'm allowed to chop it. So I got all 5 hardwood I needed from that. Lovely. So I think I can probably like chop these deadwood stumps as well, and all of this wood scrap around here as well, but I will probably go into the mines with my remaining stamina. So that will be... Ooh, it looks like my grind is a little bit low on the old fuel-y fuel, so let's fuel that up and make myself 1 hardwood plank, and that's 2 really good commissions done today. So then I'll be up to about 800. So I'm going to need another 900 points or so over the next like 15 days or so. I think it might be close, but I think I might struggle unless I get extra for quests. Okay, let's go repair the window. Maybe I'll get some workshop reputation points for repairing the window as well. Let's see. Talk to Yan. Who of course is putting his feet up on the desk in the Commerce Guild. Someone actually wrote that in apparently 600 hours of playing this, they've only seen Yan actually go to his workshop once. And that doesn't surprise me at all.
Ah, fix that window, eh? Oh, splendid! Another fine contribution to Sandrock on behalf of the Commerce Guild. I'm sure they'll have a few kind words to throw my way at the next fireside, eh?
Sure, I'm certain they will. Workshop rep plus 15. So what are we at now? 539. We need to get up to 200. I definitely think we're going to be able to get up to 600 today. And you all thought I was crazy going around finding all the chests. But no, I was just being awesome. I don't know, like, because I know people were really annoyed that I didn't find all the chests in the last one. So there's going to probably be a few people who are really happy with that. Okay, that's both my commissions done. Come, come, horsey boy. That's rad. There's someone just over here that I can help. Oh, sorry, Grace. I don't mean to bump into you. Oops. Alright, so it's Ryan.
Hello.
You're very welcome. So that will be actually be 51 workshop reputation because of the
Oh, thank you.
The ad. Okay. Right then, horsey, where's the other one? Oh, I need one more copper pipe. What? I don't have enough copper pipes. Oops. Go back and make sure that one more is being made. I don't think I have enough copper bars for it. I did put more on though, didn't I? So let's just check. Okay. I bet there'll be some copper bars here. Yeah. This is why I did that. I'm trying to grind up copper and things because copper is useful. Grinder, copper pipe, one. Build that will take a minute and 7 seconds. Do I have any other quests that I am doing at the moment? Zero, zilcho, none. Just that one for Burgess. Okay. I don't really want to go into the mines right now. I would rather just wait for that, to be honest. Anything that will give me extra trees. EXP for mining increase, that would be useful. Extra stamina points would be useful. Jew salvaging scrap. I think overall stamina would be best here now. Gold and diamonds in junk piles might be a good one as well, because they're very good presents. I never gave that my diamond that I found in that chest to Yan, did I? I feel almost like I don't want to. So one thing that I could do, which would be a really cool thing to do while I'm waiting for my copper pipe, would be to head up to the junkyard and actually just pull apart all the junk up here. That'd be a good thing to do for 1 minute. Because you always want to be doing something that's like collecting a material if you've got a minute, basically, in this. But you can't afford to let the story quests lapse either, because if you don't do those fast enough, then Yan will beat you as well. It's also a very good use of my stamina for the day. I think I'm doing alright. I mean, I'm getting good friendship points with people. I'm getting good progress going through the story. And I am doing reasonably well with commissions. I'm not forgetting to run ads. I'm making sure that ads add to my reputation. So that should all add up to my overall goal, hopefully. Right, let's stick some stuff in the recycler now. So I've got a bit of copper, rubber, and mechanical scrap. So let's stick the copper and mechanical scrap in. Then I'm going to have a quick look at how my water tank is doing. Make sure that that's not too bad. No, that's absolutely fine. 60%. The final copper pipe is done. So that means I can now go and give that to Mr. Burgess. I'm all done then.
On behalf of the Church of the Light, I thank you and Mion for your dedication to Telesis.
You're welcome.
Everything you two did looks great. And I might add that my strolls around the oasis are much more pleasant now. The spruced up old barrier looks so... fancy. Fancy? Fancy? No?
Okay, I got the laugh.
Mion laughed at that.
So... yeah, that fence is the subject of many a pun today.
Well,
clearly.
Thanks again. Gotta go.
Here's your commission.
Thank you.
The church has got 2% cooler. And so that was a workshop reputation of 41. So overall between those two, we got 92 reputation that day. I'm pretty sure I did get to my 600 that I wanted to get to. Ah! Sorry, horse parkour, gotta be quick. All right, I'll shut. Wanna go check. Yeah, 631. And I am now less than 100 points behind Slack. But the thing is, like, Yan has 1,700 odd rep points, but the rep points he started with have really sort of, like, he doesn't add to them very much. You know, she doesn't move forward. It's just like sort of a... it's like he gave himself a weird head start, but now does no work, which actually wouldn't surprise me if he just made that up at the beginning of the year or something, or just didn't... took last year's results and just carried them over or something. I really don't know. Poor Mian is way behind. So yeah, I will 100% be second as long as I take two commissions a day. Right, so I want to head into the... I might have to do that in the morning, actually. It is getting really late. Super late. So is there anything else I can do in the meantime? Could I bash a few rocks? Anything just to get some use out of the day? And use up my stamina a little bit on something. Maybe I could hit some of these harder rocks. I think the bronze hammer will... do that? I think. Yeah. So we can hit these guys as well now. And I get bloodstones out of those, which are always quite useful. And then maybe tomorrow I can go and get some tin and copper. I do have bronze bars on the go. I do have copper on the go. I do have ores for all of that. But I do need to keep on mining them as well. I need to just make sure that I don't sort of fall behind the curve with my gathering. So just make sure I have lots of rock, lots of dinas, lots of stuff from these hard rocks. Probably one more and then I'll probably need to head home, I think, because it's getting very close to midnight and I would like to be in bed by midnight. Ideally. So that's definitely something that you can do if you've just got a little bit of stamina left and a little bit of time at the end of your day. You can just bash a few rocks around the place and I promise you that will all come in handy later. So having a stockpile of things from the rocks around your home, picking up various scrap piles, going up to the junkyard, all little things that you can just do at the end of the day that will improve what you have. How much you have to do your commissions with. So, tis a new day. Tis a Sunday.
Pass me more.
Are they throwing rocks at Burgess? Eagle of scum.
Retreat!
We'll do something about them. There's something happening by the oasis. I should check it out. Let's go to the oasis first and we'll come back for that letter, okay? We need to get there right away. They were being mean to Burgess, and Burgie Boy is just like my fave. I love him. I was convinced that he was going to be an evil villain. But I will not tell you whether or not that comes to pass, because I'm not going to give you spoilers.
Did you see that? Those darn gigglers are at it again. Look at this mess. They're muddling up our water. I honestly don't know what it is they have against us.
They just want the gigglers to take over the world, that's all.
Do you mind helping out with the trash around the oasis? The longer they're in the water, the higher the risk of contamination, so we must hurry.
All right then. Those gigglers, they need to get taken down. They're throwing bones at him. That's so mean. Wow. Are there any more ones? Oh, here we are, here we are, here we are. Waste residue and old newspapers. Wow. They did throw rather a lot of stuff at me. At Burgess, sorry, not me. Any more? Okay, talk to Burgess soon. No, we got it all, I think. Wow. Evil gigglers. Burgie Boy, I cleaned it up.
Hey, I saw you helping out. Thanks, we all appreciate it. If you found any valuables in the trash, you can keep those. Isn't that great?
Did they throw valuables? I didn't find any. Oh, I got some water and 50 goals and 50 Burgess relationship. But nothing for my workshop. So I'm going to head over to the Commerce Guild and grab a couple commissions. I'm hoping I can get some really decent ones like I did yesterday. It would be amazing. Let's see. Okay, so a sand hat. 5 days to finish it. Bronze bars, I could definitely do that one. I'm going to do the sand hat, and I'm going to give my only sand hat in. And then hopefully the tailor's bench will be done soon. I'm gonna go check on that actually, because I don't know how long is that gonna take. Seems like it's been ages. Because I wanted to make the tailor's bench next so I could make sand hats, because they keep coming up on the thing. Okay, so let's have a look at this then. Unknown letter. Dear Chicken Liver, hey dummy, guess what? I'm the most evilest killer there is, and I just stole your builder. What? Builder's license. Guess now you'll have nothing better to do but spend more time with your friends, huh? Don't even think about trying to hunt me down. I'll smash you in your stupid goggles. Then show you why everyone is afeard of me. Killer E, criminal mastermind. Day 14, summer of year 1. A builder who wears goggles? This must be meant for me, aren't you? Okay, so Nia, it's me again. So, your ma has already replaced you. I guess she got tired of waiting for you to come home and instead found a smarter, more beautiful, kinder version of you. I was even at your house yesterday. She cooked a massive meal for everyone. During dinner, they were telling stories about when we were young. A little embarrassing, if I'm honest. But it made me laugh regardless. Kept reminding me of how you left, though. I mean, it's not that I'm sad or anything. I just kind of miss our stupid adventures. You remember that tree we used to climb when we were young? The one you fell out of and everyone was fussing over you? Ugh. I remember you got to miss a whole week of school. I was so jealous. Anyway, direct to Luau. Somehow managed to revive it. It started blooming and everything. He's been doing some research lately that will bring dead trees back to life. I'm sending a photo of it. It's really awesome. You wouldn't understand though, so you just stick to your building, okay? Speaking of dead things, how's Sandrock treating you? I heard it used to be an oasis, but then desertification killed everything, bringing in the sandstorms and droughts. It's actually super interesting how it happened. Well, I hope you don't get blown away in the sandstorms. I know you. There's no way you're hiding when they come. All right. I'm going to tell you something, but you have to promise you won't laugh. I learned to knit the other day. I know what you're thinking, but no, I'm actually pretty good at it. Your ma taught me how. By the way, she told me you have to wear... to tell you to wear the t-shirt she made you. Anyway, I sent you a scarf I made. You have to wear it whenever there's wind or something. You can wrap it around your head like one of those stupid old world cartoons you used to watch. Right, my hands are starting to ache now, so I'm going to stop writing. Don't miss me too much. Your friend forever, Nia. And it's outstanding quality. It's warm and full of love, but doesn't give me any stats, so I'm not going to wear it. Sorry, Nia. Oh, it's waiting for a reply. I love the scarf. I can't believe the tree. In Sandrock, trees are so special, you can't cut them down. The only way to get wood is to buy it from the store. No, I'm going to go with the scarf, I think. As the reply, I think I'm going to say, I love your scarf, because I think that will get me probably more friendship points. Not that I'm, you know, playing to min-max or anything. No, no, no. So. Bronze bars. Already done. Sand hat. Already done. So I'm going to go and hand those commissions in. That'll be like probably another 100 workshop points or something. I don't know actually. Let's see how many it was expected. $64 and $51. Yeah, that'll be 110 or so. So let's go and find Pen and Rocky. My poor little Cato and Doggo are not getting presents today. I still haven't gone sand fishing. The thing is, you've got all these things going on, and then you're like, yeah, and I should also do some sand fishing. I don't know, Rocky might be at church because it's a Sunday, so... Yeah, everyone's in here. Wonderful. Hey, Rocky. I unfortunately do
Why
have to...
Why are you still here? Are you expecting a handout? Now listen here. When I was your age, I was taking care of 15 yakmel, 45 chickens, 12 brothers and sisters, and nobody, not once, not never, I said nobody, ever gave me nothing for free.
So I am guessing this is his funny little rant, actually.
So I ask myself now, what in the Sam heck would I be doing if I...
Just had to back away slowly. Smart choice.
Mm-hmm.
I'm Giggler, fellas, picking on poor Burgess. I'd like to see him try the same thing at the salvage company. Me and the boys don't take kindly to garbage rain.
But what's a builder like me to do?
Thanks, builder. You know, I can't remember being so unupset as a builder before. Keep up the good work. And then let's go find Pen over the other side. I love Hugo's piano playing. Actually, technically organ playing, I guess. Pen, I need to be able to, like... get to you. There we are. Aha! That Giggler leader thinks he's all that because he landed a shot into our oasis from that distance, but he's not. I could sink from one from twice that far. Of course you could, Pen. Of course you could.
Uh-huh.
I had to give away my sand hat. He doesn't even remember what he needed it for. Oh, I'm so sad. I'm hoping I can make another one. Otherwise, I got to buy the horrible goggles. From Vivi's store, which I will need to do eventually as well. Right, so. Oh, no, no, no. Back around, back around, back around. Research center. I want to check on my research in here. Need to know. How that is going, or if it even is going. Oh, one more day and I'll get the tailoring machine, so that's okay. That's not too bad at all. I'm gonna try my best to always take the 2-star commissions if I can. So let's see, I don't think we're quite ahead of Slack yet, but I think we're gonna be in second place like super soon, so let's go look, keep an eye on it. And then I'll run around the place. There seems to be quite a few quests today, so I'll run around the place finding those. Like, why is Mian's building license being taken for ransom? Also, like, I can almost guarantee that's Elsie. like, criminal E? Really? Criminal E? The prankster? I know I am. I'm in second place. So I have to make up 1,100 in 14 days. I could do it, you know, if I can get 100 a day. Totally could. And also, what? If I could get large sandacuda or large lungfish, I could get some really big points here. I might need an advanced sandfish trap for that though. Can I buy the advanced sandfish recipe yet? Might not be able to get it yet, you see. No, I can. But I need an intermediate work table. Ah, okay. And I need steel bars for it. So no, I don't think I can get those large fish. Someone was saying that I can't get them with a basic sand trap, and that's why I'm, like, struggling. I don't know how true that is or whether it's just extremely difficult. But it's probably best not to take those in case I can't get them. So there's something going on at the game center. There's something going on at the... I've just been up at the temple. And then also something about keeping up with the yakmels. Okay. I'll go to the church first, since it's the furthest out. I'll go up these stairs because they are so much easier to navigate. Look, I didn't even run Nemo over, look. So yeah, something going on in here apparently, even though I was just in here.
Did you hear that, Elsie?
This sermon is so much different than in Tulsa's new relic technology. Oh, just you, Sheila.
Sorry, you scared me. I am a bit on edge. Today, when I woke up, I discovered someone stole my builder's license. I can't take any commissions without it.
That makes sense.
And it'll take a while to apply for a replacement. Huh? What did you say? Criminal mastermind? Let me see that letter. Chicken liver? Stupid goggles? My goggles aren't stupid. They're in style. And some criminal mastermind? I couldn't even get the letter to the right person. This makes things worse than I thought.
What can a humble saloon?
The Civil Corp should hear about this right away. Hey, wait a sec. You're a key witness in this case. Can you help me out and gather some evidence?
Sure, I'll just go to Elsie's house and say, hey, was it you?
I knew I could count on you. What can we do? What can we do? I feel like I can't even think straight without my license.
So this is either the result of me getting to close to buddy status with Mian, and that I hadn't ever had her quests before, or it's a new quest for full release. Not sure which.
My license must have been stolen.
Never
this
done
morning.
This before.
I still had it last night. Why don't you check with people who wake up really early? Maybe someone saw something. I'll go talk with the Civil Corps.
All right then. Also, Burgess has something to say.
Greetings! Looking kind of thirsty. Need some water? A ransom note? Theft of a legal document? A new super criminal setting their sights on Sandrock citizens? Forgive me, but this is a lot to take in.
Don't those two look kind of handsome together? They do, don't they?
I haven't seen any suspicious activity, and I'm usually pretty vigilant, as I think everyone knows. Then again, this morning I ran into Cooper, who had a long anecdote to regale. A very, very, very long anecdote.
This sermon is really surprise, surprise.
Well, I won't let it happen again. You have my word. I will have my eyes all over Sandrock, and I won't so much as blink until we find this criminal.
Right, so the next person to ask would be Owen. Luckily, everybody is already in the temple, so it's like
can
super.
I go?
Oh,
a ransom note for Mian's builder's license? Well, you don't need me to tell you how weird that is. Have you tried asking Jasmine if she saw anything? She does a lot of the mail delivery in town. I'll be on the lookout for that thief as well.
Good advice. Jasmine.
Oh, hi. How are you?
Good.
Oh, Peach. A criminal mastermind? This sounds like one of my mystery books. Cool. I mean, oh no. But I didn't deliver this letter. I always remember the addresses on the letters perfect, so I never take a letter to the wrong house. The bad person must have delivered the letter themselves. Wow. I was in danger.
So now all I've done is upset the small child. Okay, Coop. What do you know about this?
What letter? I never saw anything like that. Maybe it's just a prank. Forget about it. Killer? Ha! That's nonsense.
It's either you or Elsie.
Ransom letter? Why, of all the cotton picking nonsense?
Oh, yeah. That's
ain't no
so
criminal
mean.
Mastermind.
I'm real right
Killer
like
E?
That.
That's the stupidest name I ever heard. Just one of them kids let their imagination run away with itself, that's all. I ain't heard nothing about no ransom letter. And even if I did, I didn't. So quit asking. Get that letter out of my face.
Even if I did, I didn't. Even if I did, I didn't.
You've returned, so I might yell at you some more. Now, where was I? Ah, yes. Now, where do you get off going around asking for handouts? Good, honest, hard-working people like yours truly are out in the fields, breaking their backs, sweating their behinds off.
You decided to back away slowly. Trail's gone cold. Wait for the Civil War to finish their investigations. Okay, so we've got to wait for them now. What else is going on in the town of Sandrock? So, we have a delivery trainee. But there's also something keeping up with the Yakmels. Oh, why can't the horse jump over that barbed wire? It's so out of here. Oh, there's a chest around here somewhere, apparently. Is there another one up in the sky? Oh, good grief. How am I getting that one? That's got to be the top of the museum, hasn't it? Either that or the top of the game center or the top of the clinic. I've got my throwing rocks on me. Yeah, it looks like we could jump up on top of the clinic. I don't know how far on top. No, it's still miles away though. Can I get any higher? A little bit. No, okay, I don't think so. I don't think it's a clinic thing. I think it might be a museum thing. And yes, I know, I am getting distracted. From whatever it was I was supposed to be doing, which I have no idea about. I was really, really focused on doing something. But then I saw a chest and it was like, no, I must get it. Okay. Oh, I might want to get back on the horse. Oh no, I got invisible. Ah. Okay, I'm visible again. Yay. No, can't get on there. From there, maybe. Still not? Wow, can you really knock out on top of the museum?
Our amazingly adventurous aristocrats.
No, no, no. It looks like, it really looks like you should be able to. But no. It's not happening. So so there's two things now I have no idea how to get. Maybe if I go around here. Oh, look. I get around the back. Aha! Well, look at this. I can get all the way up here. Oh! Backing up? Oh, no. Oh, okay. Well, I got the chest. Oh. Alright, then. It's definitely possible to run up the back of here, though. Get that chest. I just want to be more careful. There we are. From here, with the throwing stone. Okay, cute. Really? That looked like it was going to hit. Gotcha! It took two throwing stones to do, but yes, I got it. I am happy for the rest of the day now. There's my horse. I feel unsafe here. There's a lot of very fiery ants around. So yeah, that's how you do that one. Well, latest on SheLab's guide to the cave here. I'm going in this cave. Ah! Oh no! It's a cave full of horrible things that are like level 50. Let's run away. Yeah, I don't like that cave. Maybe that's a late game thing for me. Can we get back up here? Yeah, I don't go there again. It's horrible. Right, so, there's something going on around here.
Wow!
Dag nabbit hog wash and fiddlesticks. Mabel! Did you leave the gate open? No, dear.
Oh.
And where in the Sam Hill are all the Akmel? Looks like your fence is broken there, partner.
Hmm.
Well, I don't recall asking you a gosh darn thing, stranger. Where you get off going around criticizing the handiwork of good ordinary citizens such as myself? Excuse me. You gave me hiccups, Coop. How am I to know you ain't had some part in the conspiracy to release my Yakmels, huh? Return to the scene of the crime, have you? Oh, relax, I'm a builder here to help. Well, now I done heard tell there was supposed to be a couple of new builders round town of late. Didn't expect such a young'un, but guess it ain't much of a surprise now, neither. Ever since our water supply started drying up, good health's been scarce as hen's teeth. Can't blame him though, ain't much to be made out here these days. Why, when I was your age, young'un, the Sandrock I knew was practically paradise. That's right, we had eggs in every hen nest, two socks for every pair of feet, and water, precious, delicious water. There was plenty to go around, not like these days. Cooper's wiry voice, which once grated against you like sandpaper, is now sounding like a soft lullaby whispered into your ear. And the cacti. Blah, 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 keep listening. Blah, 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 blah. This is like the Charlie Brown thing with the teacher. Blah, 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 blah. You begin to question your own sanity and whether or not Cooper possesses some sort of an extraordinary ability to manipulate time. We're gonna keep listening. Blah, 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 blah. Various slang words. Goals at that time. Blah, blah.
Yeah?
Make sure it's a bronze fence. I know what you're thinking. The whole rest of the fence is made of wood. Well, guess what? We ain't allowed to chop down trees no more, so better make it bronze, you rutabaga, you. Ah, make sure it's a bronze fence. I'll get right to
Thank
it.
Thank you.
Finally, a young in here, earning a keep. Listening to Copa's entire rant made you more disciplined, and your max stamina's increased by 2. Which is exactly why I listened to that. 2 max stamina is useful. Okay, so we have to make some thick rope and bronze bars. Are you kidding me? He actually does want a bronze fence. Utterly ridiculous, but I guess that's what the man wants. That's what the man gets. My inventory is also full. Let's do a little quick sort into my chests. Give me a few extra spaces. I'm not a big one for like tidying up huge amounts of my inventory, but I do try and keep it relatively empty. Do a bit of a tidy up every now and again. I'll make the rest of my bronze, and I will make the rest of the copper. I do need to go into the ruins and get some tin at some point. It's getting late as well, so I don't know whether maybe I would be better off waiting to do Coop's quest and just going straight into the ruins and getting some tin so that I don't run out of bronze. Because majority of my commissions that are going to need something like that are going to be requiring tin. And I will not have long. So I'm just going to go in until midnight, basically. I have a reason for stopping my horse there. If you... And I'm already on low hit points from falling off the rock earlier. But if you fall off here, you die. Fall off here, you will literally die. It is really high up and you will take a whole load of fall damage and you will just die. Oh. That was not what I expected. I just came in here to get a bit of tin, but oh well.
Well, story this is a surprise. I predicted that the Civil Corps would show up any minute now to rescue me, but I didn't expect them to send some random individual. Nevertheless, you're here now. Proceed with your extraction plan. I won't complain. You do have a plan, right? Wait, wait. By the look on your face, perhaps you're not a rescuer, but a fellow prisoner instead. Oh. Okay, well, you can join the club and sit over there while we wait for the proper authority to appear.
Well, that's not an attitude of champions, is it, Chi? No. Let's get out of here.
Hold on. I recognize you. You're the new builder. Perhaps we don't have to wait. With my intellect and your logistical aptitude, there may yet be new possibilities to extricate ourselves from this predicament. Let's look around this area to see if there's anything we can use to escape, relics or otherwise.
Okay, so we have cheese pick hammer, which is, I believe, so people were wanting me to get this. Didn't actually have to be that friendly with Chi for this. Chi is only at something like 10 points with us at this point, and this still procced. So the person telling me I needed to get like loads of points, I don't actually think you do. You just have to be in the right place at the right time. There's a damaged ladder piece.
Wood, stone, metal, scraps. These things are useful to you, are they not, Builder?
Yes.
I must admit, I find using such basic components to solve our predicaments somewhat inelegant.
Well, you gotta start somewhere.
Regardless, Builder, I recommend you collect these materials. They may prove useful in our journey to the service.
Well, that's kind of what I was doing. But anyway, cheese pick hammer, let me just show you. I think it's slightly better. It's a rare upgraded one. So the tool strength is 20 instead of 15. There's a dig radius of 11%, a minor yield of an extra 10%. and might drop extra resources on quarrying. So that is what I shall be using for now. It doesn't need to be on a hot slot at all.
This machine reminds me of something very obscure. Something you never would have heard of. In certain old world literature, it was imagined that time travel might one day be possible. If only I could go back in time and warn myself not to travel into this tunnel.
I'll have wishes for
I could
horses.
Also tell my past self that you'd be falling down here around this time, and then sent myself to rescue you, solving this entire ordeal. That is, if my past self wasn't too busy right now.
Well, that sounds incredibly paradoxical, and I think it's better if we just build a ladder.
Wishful
honestly.
Thinking, I'm afraid. Also, the fact that I did not meet myself before falling in here means that I do not uncover the secrets of time travel on this particular timeline. Or is there a reason I would have allowed this to happen?
So you could have extra quality time.
In any case, this machine would probably do us better as scrap. Can you break it down with your pick hammer?
No, I'll take it down with your pick hammer. Got microchips, bronze plates, and copper screws. Lovely. And a piece of ladder. And another piece of ladder.
Looking up towards the skies for answers. That's entirely the reason I'm in this predicament in the first place.
Were you looking up at the sky and fell in a hole, Chi?
Well, Builder, our objective is rather straightforward, is it not? Exit through that gap above. Indeed, a mere difference in altitude has managed to contain us here.
I could build something here to get us closer to the exit if I had enough materials.
Pay me no mind, Builder. Complaining won't improve our situation. I suggest we continue looking around.
Okay. So I need one more ladder piece, two more bronze plates, and four more copper screws. Okay. Probably back here somewhere.
Perhaps if this machine were repurposed somewhat, it could be fitted with an engine. With enough propulsion, we could likely fly out through that hole in the ceiling. Any minor miscalculation in trajectory might cause us to die, which would be suboptimal. Let's put this one down as Plan Z. Perhaps just use your pick hammer to break it down into scrap. I'll leave it to your discretion.
I'm going to make scrap out of it and pick up this last ladder piece, and that should helpfully get us out of here, and then I can go looking for the tin I actually wanted to find. Oh no! I think I might just have to... I just cleaned this inventory. I clearly need more inventory slots. I've got like 5 grand in the bank. It's all those chests I keep opening up. Okay, let's have a look then. So, install... the ladder.
Oh! Using the environment to bridge the gap between us and that opening up there. Brilliant!
I know.
In any case, let's save our celebrations for the surface. After you, Builder.
Street smarts versus academic smarts. Sometimes the former is better.
Finally! How serendipitous that you were the next to fall into that cavern.
Why did you come
Science.
Here?
According to Civil Corps survey reports, I deduced the likelihood of uncovering a usable equatorial mount in these ruins to be upwards of 99.9%. Unfortunately, despite my in-depth and thoroughly digestible explanation, none of the Civil Corps members were able to comprehend the significance of an equatorial mount. Thusly, it became imperative that I come here myself, and hence, our untimely meeting. My venture proved not only unfruitful, but also has caused a delay in my research. I must be heading back to the research center to make up for lost time. Perhaps I'll hire someone to continue the search for me.
What's an equatorial
mount? I'm glad you asked. In order to facilitate the expeditious referencing and notation of celestial coordinates, a rare old world relic is required. The equatorial mount. By aligning one rotational axis of a telescope's mount parallel to our planet's axis of rotation, an internal mechanism known as a clock drive will rotate the telescope over a period of a day in contrast with the rotation of our planet in order to compensate for its motion.
Right, so it means it can look at the same part of space for a long time?
Once the state has been achieved, one need only adjust the right ascension and declination dials on the equatorial mount to find any celestial body in the sky in only a matter of moments. But in any case, I must be going. I will find some way to seek out an equatorial mount at a later date.
Let me help you.
Render unto builders the things that are builders. Indeed, you would be much more suited to the task. Surely you'll be able to find pieces of an equatorial mount in the abandoned ruins, likely on a lower level. Once you've found the pieces by diving in the ruins, you can use the restoration machine at Katori's museum to make it whole again. Please bring it to me at that point, and not before. Goodbye.
Very well. I would like to go to level 4. The equatorial mount, I believe, is somewhere around level 11. It's also on level 10. It's also on level 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, but not 4. So if we can get to level 5, we can start looking for it. What time of day are we at now? Oh, we didn't use any time. We didn't use any time. So I can still go and look for... I used a bit of stamina, but I can still go in here and look for tin. Which is fantastic. I may have mined all the tin out of this area. I need to do a little reset soon. Get some data discs as well, which is... quite useful because tomorrow we will finish the machine, the tailoring bench, and we'll be able to start researching something new. So it'd be good if we could actually research that thing. Is it here? Yes. Also good if we could get through to the equatorial mount. It doesn't look like there's any tin around here at all. It's most disheartening. However, if I manage to... Oh yeah, a little bit of tin there. Lovely. And we can get through to level 5 as well, which means we can start looking for an equatorial mount too. So if I see any bits of one, I'll dig them up. I am mostly here for the metal. Huh. Oh, are we really having problems with the... I need to get some more, So how much are we... It's costing us 42 golds per backpack slot now. But basically, by expanding the backpack a lot, it... Oh! McMole! Oh, why is he all the way up there? It's so annoying. Gotcha! No, of course he showed up when I got no inventory space. And honestly, even my chests are full, so this is going to be a thing. I've got more gold, you see, and I really do like getting gold from the moles, so... Half 10 now, so probably should consider getting back very soon. Takes a while to get out of here, so yeah, I'm gonna... Gonna head out. But I got myself a little bit of tin. We got ourselves to level 5, so I can start looking around for... Actually, that's not even a good idea. Looking around for equatorial mounts. For chi. I will need to do the Yakmel quest as well next episode. But, yeah, I think we've done really well today. Especially with the whole commission thing. I'm really proud of myself for getting 4 commissions done in 2 days. That's not easy. Okay, let's have a quick look at my machines before I go to bed. So let's see if there's any scrap I can pull apart, which it can. Copper scrap as well. The furnace, I can make more bronze bars on it, and I can also give it a bit of fuel. And we can do more copper bars over here. And also give that more fuel. Did the recyclers need more fuel? Yes. And yes. And water tank is still fine, it's 50%. Do a little top up very soon on it though, I think. And time for bed? In time for midnight. I could not have timed that more perfectly if I tried. So there we are. Another day done and another episode done. And that was huge. Ad cancelled. I need to remember that for next time because I need to put that ad on before I even take any more commissions. But anyway, that is it for today. I hope you enjoyed the episode. If you did, then please do leave me a like below. If you'd like to see more, then please subscribe. I'll let you know when the videos are out. I hope to see you next time. In the meantime, please look after yourselves and keep being awesome.